Thank you. pushing each other.
Except it doesn't change. It goes all the way. See, this one is only about the last 20 meters. It's like 33. Below that, it's like 31, 32, I guess. I don't know. And it gets gradually steeper. Then, like, the last 20 or so meters, it gets really steep. It's like 33%.
Oh, it's towards the end of the ride. It's 33.
Right here.
Because
right
I just got halfway up Baxter. I was okay, and I had to stop. I got a third up, then I started zigzagging.
Yeah, see, Baxter's the same, almost the same all the way down. It's not near as long.
Right.
But it's the same, as this top part here.
Oh! Okay. Maybe I'll give it a second shot. I just couldn't, because the front tire kept coming up.
Exactly. That's the
and I couldn't.
You could take some air on the front tire, then you know, just a little bit better.
Really?
Yeah, I
know. Also the turn?
Yeah. But what I did was I took bar ends. You know, to fill out. Like,
yeah.
To get me a little bit further out. The front end still wanted to lift, but better than the road back.
There was a guy, did you see the guy that went straight up? He used my bike. He goes, can I borrow your bike? And he almost went straight. I said, well, I know my bike can do it.
That was the guy with no number, right?
That was the guy with no number.
What a stupid ass. All you need is just an
e-bike. I'm sorry. He just asked if I could borrow his bike, and he had to go. He didn't want to go through that. He just, I'm sorry. I should have told him to do that. He was fine.
So it was an e-bike? Oh, is that it? Well, then it wasn't an e-bike.
It was just a mountain bike. He was riding my bike. Gotcha. Yeah, he did this whole thing about 4 years ago, but when he came straight up, I was like, oh my gosh.
That wasn't Mario, was it?
No, his name is Chris.
Oh, okay.
All right.
Six people made it.
bunch of spectators in it. Like half those guys got to drive.
At least 15 signed up, and that's how many beyond 15. I only get the name. The names are down there. I don't think the names up here for me.
You should have seen that guy wipe. Did you hear the story? What happened to that dude? Oh, there was a guy. He wiped out halfway up, and he had the cleats on. He locked in.
Oh shit! He went sliding down the hill.
And he was sliding down the hill. He couldn't stop. And he basically dove head first. He fell head first into the planter. Fortunately, there were no sprinkler heads there. They were ripping his face. And he split his lip open. We watched the whole thing. It was just about the Royal Desk was. He couldn't stop.
Oh.
He had the biker cleats. It was just a slow motion horror scene.
You ride this
guy.
Hey, let's put it this way.
Yeah, it just happened an hour ago.
I
was like, holy shit.
We came up here one day, right along the triangle, and he was looking so high.
Right.
And I told Brian, look, whatever you do, if you can't make it, turn around and come back down because you might flip out. And he started up there about a third of the way up. He said, oh, give me a shot. And just as I was about to clip in, I hear click, click. I go, oh shit. And I just unclipped again and watched Brian go into rock climbing mode. He had his back in one hand, his other hand was sliding on the ground. Feet were spread out, we were sliding down and going. And he away, yeah. Oh, finally pointed back down the hill by about 15 degrees. And I barely got it back around to go back up again. And after that point, I didn't tack anymore. I just came straight up the hill from there.
Did you ever take it straight up?
Oh, from then on, I always did.
Straight up?
Straight up. Let's do that traffic. I mean, I don't plan on coming up there multiple times, but at least I've been on the base.
What about out of the saddle?
Well, for me, I was so strong then I just sat down. I never stood up. I might start off standing, but I sit down. By the time I got to the top, I didn't need to stand. I had more than enough power. The fact that I stood up and pedaled, I probably pulled something off the wrong ear.
Six, three, four, five, six.
Yeah. Actually, one guy that came up twice, up six, was 78 years old.
So he counted for two, if there were only five.
No,
six, including his two.
No, there were six people, but he made it twice. One of the guys done it twice, and the other guy has done it 34 times. He's trying to get fast for 60.
Yeah.
I probably should go to that or SPDs or whatever.
I was just setting up.
Oh man! I wonder if he's still down there.
Hope so.
He came
he flew in from Maryland just for the hill climb.
Did he say this?
Yeah, he flew in last night.
Chuck? It's Chuck, that's good.
Yeah. Yeah, I think what he's gonna do though, he didn't have a patch to prove it. He climbed up halfway and got off the bike because he got tired. And then he rode the rest of the way. But he got video of both halves, so I think he's going to put them together and show a full climb.
Now
when I joked about it, he didn't complete
a second or third climb, didn't he?
Nope.
Oh, I thought he did.
Nope, he stopped part way.
Oh,
rested and
then
continued. I just thought to mention to him that, you know, you can stop as long as you don't take a few thousand steps.
Let's see how it's going.
I don't think.
Maybe it's because
I don't think the unicycle cares whether it's on a hillside or flat. It's still straight up and down. And if you got enough to sit there and like
that's I can do a partial one, but not a full good next.
I can do it somewhat now, but when I was racing it to go through it, I was on the track. That's why they call it track stuff. It's a lot easier on the track bike because you can put a bit there.
Yeah. So you'll say, you're in the show, just want to set it halfway up. And they never come stop coming straight up. Not the saddle. Halfway. So it's not going to stop. It's okay. But what you said, the steepest this matches the top of this.
At least, yeah.
Well,
it may
shallow somewhat the bottom.
But it's closer to the top of this all the way down. It's probably at the top, it's certainly the same.
Right.
It might even be a little bit steeper, hair steeper. I don't know. Yeah, but Baxter is the same all the way down. When you look at it, it doesn't change. You look down this, you can see where it's steep here, and about 20 yards down, it kind of gets a little shallower, slightly shallower. You can't really. Maybe you can't tell looking at it.
I don't really notice that. It looks pretty consistent.
Yeah, you can see it when you're riding it. And I know
maybe right here. Maybe yeah. Right at the
top. Because
one year we had a surveyor's log here and we checked it all the way down.
There's another guy couldn't do it. The attempt isn't an issue. The issue is I fell. I got lucky. Okay.
And now you're
afraid if I. What's the gradual way down? I don't know.
This way? Yeah, about 3 blocks that way and you're down, you come back around.
Alright.
It's not quite a steep down. So, since I saw you last, brand new ankle on the left side now. I Yes. No plates in the cool part was it was
I'm going to sell that. I'm going to shake that up for it.
both got two more weapons. She's all LA. You just say, you know, people move out of California left and right. Go home early.
Yeah. You break your own record? No, no.
No, you got the 36.
Leave me ready to
play. You're doing pretty good. You're doing
good. I'm tired of it.
Well, my plan was, when my help was ready to go, I was just going to let you keep riding and just call me and tell me what you do.
Yeah.
That's at 2:30. Hey, if you want to keep going, I didn't do it. I'll touch it. There you go, Alex.
Did that have a gummy? So I can send you a gummy.
Oh,
I can.
You just tell me. You tell me what you did. I believe you.
They put up a few hotels for a month, they're going to get
That's like the guys that were in my mother's house. They weren't paying rent, they were tearing the house up, and we still had to give them, go to court to get them out.
They were hard sale.
Yeah. Well, that's why he wound up in jail when he was over.
They were hard sale. But, yeah, I mean, these people,
I was begging some money. One of these guys who works food or something. And I needed some money to do some blood work. And I put an office figure at $8 more. And I was offering at the time, it was like $12 an hour. Way more than you could
get. He said, my bad,
wait a minute, no. He told me first thing, you can't pay me to leave this store.
Ah.
I said, you can ruin it for every other homeless guy begging on the phone. You ain't getting a penny from me.
Yeah, but he was honest.
Yeah, how's that for being?